What's up, guys? What's going on? It's Dredd, and I'm back with another video. We're on Madden 23, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Atlanta Falcons. This team got a lot different over the offseason, but they are getting a lot better. It's definitely a process, but I like where the team is headed. In the draft, went out, added Bijan Robinson. probably the best running back prospect that we've seen since Saquon Barkley, arguably better than him as a prospect, and that's saying something because Barkley was one of the best prospects we've had in a long time. He's going to be electric. He's going to be one of the best running backs in the game straight from the get-go, up there on the same tier as Barkley, McCaffrey, and whoever else you want to throw up at the top. He's that good. He can do it all. He can run. He can catch. He can run someone over. He can run around them. Whatever you need, he can do. He's going to be awesome, and I'm so excited to see what he's going to do. The rest of the offense is interesting. Drake London and Kyle Pitts, it's a good receiving duo, young, talented players. They need to both develop more, and they should both do that. I believe they will. Ridder is scary at quarterback. He's just not developed enough. He's not there yet. Maybe he takes a big leap this year. Hopefully that's the case for Atlanta fans, but I think it's probably going to end up being a new quarterback after this season. We'll see, though. Ritter's going to give it a run, and we're going to see how he does. Hopefully he's able to put something together. They picked up Matthew Bergeron in the draft. It's a good addition to the line, some depth there. Maybe he gets a starting job. We're going to give him the chance and see what he can do. Matthews, Lindstrom, and McGarry are all solid starters. We'll leave them there, and I don't even know who Dahlman is, to be honest, but he's going to start for this year. Need a wide receiver, too, really bad, absolutely. In free agency, they got Jesse Bates and Calais Campbell. Couple of big adds there. I like it. Jeff Okuda, trade target. Another big pickup there. Really, really could be exciting. He does need to develop, but he was one of the best corner prospects coming out in a while. Struggled early on, and injuries, all of that's kind of slowed him down. We'll see if he can put it together in Atlanta, but that'd be a great duo with AJ Terrell. Clark Phillips in the draft. Another guy that I like the addition. Probably not going to play much of an impact in this video, though. But the defense has playmakers, the offense has playmakers. We got to get a quarterback, we got to get a few other positions. We're going to try to make it happen. We're going to simulate this first season, see if we make the playoffs, and if we do, we're going to hop into them, try to win the Super Bowl. If we don't, we'll go into the off season, try to fix the team up, try to run it back, and see if we can win a Super Bowl in the next year. If you guys enjoy content like this, please drop a like and drop a sub. It helps me out a ton, and it really does make doing these videos that much more fun for me. We're going to get into this. I have an idea of what I want to do first, and that's actually to trade away Cordarrelle Patterson if he has any value left. We'll see if we can do that, and then we'll get into the first season. All right, we did end up getting a trade really, really quick. Patterson, a 3 and a 2, is going to get Edmonds for us. Chicago, newly acquired linebacker, they send him right to us. It makes a lot of sense for Atlanta. We really need someone speedy in there to run the middle, and he's going to do that for us. I think it's a great addition. I guess the Bears wanted to get more draft cap and wanted some weapons to help out Fields. We'll take it. It's going to work for us. I like the addition. We're going to hop into the season now and see if we can make a run to the playoffs. Well, I have absolutely no idea how we managed to get here, but we snuck into the playoffs. We did get it done. We're going to try to make a run here. We'll see what the stats look like. Crazy year from Ridder. Okay, 5,000 yards, 37 touchdowns, 16 picks is a lot. But we'll take that. That's some awesome production. 13 touchdowns and 1,000 yards for Bijan is not bad. Was hoping for a little more, but we'll take it. Drake, awesome year. Kyle Pitts, great year. Scotty Miller and Matt Collins also dropped a lot. Bijan, a little bit in the run game. We'll take, or in the pass game. We'll take it. Jermaine Edmonds played awesome. AJ Terrell played awesome. Okuda with 101 tackles. Walker also, 131 tackles. A lot of production there. Defensive line could have done a lot more, but, you know, we'll take it. We got what we got. Turnovers, sacks, yards in both the passing and the running game. I'll take it. We're going to upgrade players, see if we can win this this first playoff game. Maybe Ridder won Offensive Rookie of the Year because, obviously, as anyone that plays Madden knows, it doesn't, the rookies are going to be combined from the two classes since we're using a downloaded roster. So he may have had a shot to do that. Anyways, going against San Fran, we know San Fran's the better team overall. But it doesn't matter. We get the win and we are on on to the divisional round. That's a little ridiculous, but we'll take it. Bijan up to a 92 overall. No surprise there. He deserves it. That man's a beast. Simulating against the Packers. Again, probably the better team, but really not by that much, honestly. They do get a big win, though. They smack us. We're okay with that. I'm not mad at it. We're going to simulate to the offseason, start re-signing players, and then get into free agency. I'll see you at the first week of it. All right, so we made a quick couple of vet pickups. Sterling Shepard going to come in and be a receiver for us. I'm hoping to get another guy in the draft, maybe, but he's going to come in and help out. We needed some help there. Most of our guys ended up leaving, so he's an upgrade either way. We'll take him. And Connor McGovern, slight upgrade at center. We'll take it again. A little bit more run blocking for Bijan, a little more pass blocking for Ridder. Can't hurt. There's not really a whole lot else going on, so I think we're going to skip to the draft and hope we can make our final moves there. All right, so we're going to look at the draft now. There's two spots I really want to... Whoa, the Ravens had pick number one. What are they going to do here? Huh, that makes sense. This has got to be Caleb Williams here. We're going to look at a receiver and a defensive lineman. Corey Foreman, what? You can't tell me Washington doesn't need a quarterback there. We're going to go all the way to pick four without a quarterback. Pick five without a quarterback. Okay. Pick six? How? My God. Finally, Caleb Williams is picked at pick number seven. That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous. Caleb Williams and Drake May aren't off the board by then. I'm going to be shocked. I don't think Drake May is in this draft class, to be fair. But he's definitely got to go earlier than that. Max Johnson's here. We're going to look at receivers. I think there's a pretty clear-cut guy we're going to take here, and it's going to be Emeka Egbuka. He's on another level from these other guys. Brooks hasn't been consistent enough throughout his college career. Fleming's the option below him on Ohio State's depth chart. There's some other good guys in here. Jalen McMillan has some potential. But it's the answer seems pretty clear to me. And we need a playmaking receiver like Egbuka. We're going to go right for him. I think it's a really good fit. 95 speed is sick. Able to make guys miss left and right. He was a punt returner in college. They had him back there because he was so elusive and so electric. Good hands, good routes. He can do it all. Really crazy, crazy counterparts, Marvin Harrison. In my opinion, those are the two best receivers in college football this year. I think they're going to be just as good this next year. Excited to watch it. Let's see what we got going on defense. Can we get a defensive lineman? I'm not seeing anyone too intriguing here. I'd take like Lucas Van Ness, but he's obviously gone in real life, so I don't want to go ahead and do that. So who could I take? We'll take DJ Stackhouse, I guess. His numbers aren't bad. His projections, a block shed, and then we got some decent finesse and power moves. We'll take that. We're not going to have a third round pick, so that's going to be all we do. Ritter's in a position to succeed. The offensive line is strong. The weapons are probably the best in the league at this point, arguable. Maybe Miami or Cincinnati kind of has that, or I guess San Francisco probably has the best weapons. But Egbuka, London, Pitts, and Bijan, that's an incredible core. I love that. I think if Ritter's going to get it done, it's going to be with that squad. So we're gonna simulate this season, see if we can find a way to sneak into the playoffs, and hopefully we can make a better run this year. I will see you guys at the playoffs. Okay, so we finished with the exact same record, 9-8. But this year, we're not able to get it done. I mean, it figures the team's better, so of course we have to miss the playoffs. It's kind of how Madden rolls. It's always up and down. It's always rough. Another decent year from Ridder. I mean, 4,700 yards and 35 touchdowns is really, really good. Those are going to be close to the top of the league in both. 16 picks, though, is just too much. It's way too much. Bijan, slightly better year for him, 1,114. Four fumbles, though, is rough. 49 broken tackles, pretty good, though. Receiving, Egbuka leads the team with 1,212. London right behind him with almost 1,200. And 8, we'll take it. Pitts, great year. Shep off, I guess, is the slot guy. Solid year, too. Good production again. Passing offense was really on it. That's it's interesting to see Ridder ball out that much. Kind of not what I expected out of this video. I think the defense is probably where we struggled. We just didn't get someone that was good enough in there on the defensive line. Stackhouse ended up being decent, but not decent at rushing the passer. And that's something this team really lacks. I think we needed that, and we just didn't get it done. A lot of turnovers. That's kind of fun to see. There's a lot of turnovers there. Jesse Bates snagged 4 picks for us. Love to see that. Deflections. You know, I don't honestly know what's good in Madden for that. Not a lot of fumbles at all. The team did good. It did good. It just wasn't quite enough. It's a little disappointing to see after the team we put together. It feels really good. We'll upgrade one last time and see where we're at. I think if I simulated another season, there'd be a chance that we did something serious. But it just didn't happen this year for whatever reason, and that's okay. The team's good. It'd be a fun team to play with. I wish we'd gotten to the Super Bowl. But Atlanta fans, let me know how you guys feel about the squad. Do you guys think this would be a good kind of path for the team to take for the future? What would you guys like to see him do different? Bijan, 97 overall. Pitts, 96. Igbuka, 83. London, 88. That's a crazy core for Ritter to use. That doesn't even get into Algier. Shepard, Jonnu Smith, I guess. Great squad. Really is fun. A fun team. I'm excited to see what they do. Ritter is in a position to succeed. If he doesn't get it done, this next class of quarterbacks is awesome. Some guys that look like they're going to be really, really good in Williams and May, and some other guys that could be good in like Quinn Ewers. It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, drop a like and a sub. It'd mean a lot to me. It helps me out a ton. Trying to get back into the swing of things and get putting these videos out a little more consistently. And I hope you guys keep coming back for them. I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace, guys.